This year, this is what God said to me. Now, when you hear it, you know, you're going to say, wow. Pastor Prince, you have preached on that sermon before. I know. But God is saying that this is His year for this to happen. You ready? It's the year of His restoration. It's the year of His restoration. Everything that was robbed, defrauded, cheated, taken from you, be it man or devil, God will restore. Amen. Now, notice I did not say the devil himself will restore. Many a time we involve the devil in all this act one, act two, act three, until he's always around somewhere, okay? Honestly, God treats him as a nobody. Yes, he is present. I'm not saying the devil doesn't exist. He is behind a lot of bad things that's happening. All right, but people, we learn that when Christ died on the cross, someone said that Christ was paying the devil, who was a slave master, to release all of us from the prison of sin. No, 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 no. The devil is not that powerful. It's not in the equation at all. Christ on the cross is the love of God, paying ransom to the holiness of God, to the justice of God. It's still God. God is love. God doesn't want to destroy us. God wants us blessed. More than that, God wants us blessed in every way. It's heart of love. But God's righteousness, God's holiness says, because God is holy, God cannot pass one iota, one jot or tittle of sin. But because God is a God of grace, He can forgive it all. Amen. Pretend it does not exist in your life, God cannot. God doesn't trifle with sin. But what He cannot, He cannot pass by sin, but He can blot it out. Amen. And He has done it righteously through the cross of Calvary. Amen. Can I have a good amen? Now, folks, that's accurate preaching. Amen. So that's why we can give thanks for the remembrance of God's holiness. Why? Because Christ's death at the cross, when He shed His blood, all the divine claims of God's righteousness and holiness are fully met on our behalf through the shed blood of the Lamb. Today, God's justice is satisfied. There is no sword in God's hand. There is no judgment hanging over our head. We have no more condemnation. We have a favor that can never be broken. Unceasing favor with God. Can I have a good amen? It's going to be a year of His restoration. And when He said His restoration, I saw the word restoration and the word His restoration. And God says, this is My restoration. It's not man's restoration. And it reminds me of all the sermons I preach on restoration. How even in the 90s, I preach on restoration. Yeah. Even in the 90s, people. And I still remember one of the first revelations God gave me about restoration is this. When man restores, and I use this illustration in the 90s. When you restore a chair, when man restores, it's never the same as the original. Something is gone. When you repair a jacket, it's no more the same as the original. You look carefully, the stitching is out, you know. But when God restores, it is always greater in quality or quantity. Amen. Or both. Amen. In some cases, you cannot have quantity. You lost a wife. You lost a loved one. All right, you lost a husband. God won't give you 7 husbands. Amen. And guys, wishful thinking. You won't have 5 wives. Amen. Okay, God will give you a quality relationship that is 7 times better. Amen. Amen, people? So we know that. And today we're going to show you the basis of that. But let's plunge right into this year of 2015 and see what God has for us. Are you ready, people?
Yes.
All right, first and foremost, He's going to restore to you. Only God can do this. No professional, no one you go to, there's no professional today that can do this for you. Joel 2:25, God says, I'll restore to you the years. I will give back to you the years that the locust has eaten, the cankerworm, the caterpillar, the palmer worm, my great army which I sent among you. God says, you rebel against me, you sin against me. You do not know that whenever you do that, I'm still God. I love you. Time doesn't exist with me. Time, though, exists with you. every time you indulge yourself in sin, every time you allow sin to, you set yourself back. The times you spend in sin are wasted time. The years you spend in sin are wasted years. But God is so good that God said that if you return to Him, if you trust Him, He can even restore to you the years. Is it plural, people? Yes, it's plural. The years. When God says He restored the years, I'm telling you people, He will restore the years. And I feel like stopping here and preaching to you how some of the people, the humanists, they try to find fault with the scriptures, and they say that the scriptures here in Judges and what is mentioned here in Acts, it seems like it differs because there are some missing years. Well, guess what? All the missing years are years when Israel was in bondage. Before God raised another judge, they were in bondage for 20 years or for 50 years. Then God raised another judge, like Samson. You put all the years of bondage together, you find the missing years that the critics are saying that is missing. Amen. In other words, as far as God is concerned, when His people are out of fellowship with Him, the people are not, with Him, those are wasted years. Those are wasted time. Well, our team for this year, 2015, we're going to say, no more. Amen. No more, amen? Amen. And this verse I'm about to show you right now came to me first on restoration. I think I was awake after that when I saw the word restoration. And I'll tell you more about my dream in a while's time. But one of the verses that came is this. God is saying, I heard this verse saying, ringing in my spirit. And I know I read it somewhere in the past because it's not like it came for the first time. But honestly, I didn't really bother about it. But this verse keep on ringing in my spirit. And no one is saying, restore. No one is saying, restore. I feel like God is saying, it's the cry of His heart. God is saying, my people do not believe I can restore. Many of them are thinking naturally, all right? None is saying restore, therefore they are in bondage. And I quickly, start looking for that verse. That shows that verse, that even though I may have read it before, I believe I've read it before, but I don't really know where it's from, which book it's from. It's not a book, it's not a verse that we expound on. I found it, and guess what? God is right on the fact of what He's saying, but this is a people robbed and plundered. Have you felt robbed and plundered lately? All right, we don't care whether it's man or devil, okay? All of them are snared in holes and they are hidden in prison houses. They are for prey and no one delivers for plunder. And no one says restore. That's the one I heard. No one says restore. Because for you to say restore, you got to believe that God is a restoring God. You know, so since then, this past few weeks, this past days rather, you know, since I received that word, everything that happens, you know, in my life, I'll just say, Lord, restore. You know, if I forget things, God says, son, say restore, restore my mind, restore, restore. Everything, I just say restore, because only one word only. None says restore. And I was playing with the idea of restore in terms of R-E-S. Then there's a cross in the center, O-R-E. Thought that's kind of cool. The year of restore, however, will not cut it. Anyway, look up here. This is the year of His restoration. Praise God. It will all come together. All the broken pieces, everything that you have lost will all come back, amen, for the year of His restoration. Okay, another area God wants to restore. Now He's going to restore all the areas of your life, okay, but predominantly these are the areas He's going to focus on if you are in these areas. The next one is He restored you the years. The next one is He restore your soul, your mind, your emotions. If it's out of sync with the flow of the Holy Spirit, all right, it's out, it's no more, you know, it's depressed all the time. You're thinking negative all the time. He's going to restore your soul this year, all right? Psalms 23, He restores my soul, nefesh. He restores my soul, nefesh. Amen. The third area He's going to do for you is this. And this is quite interesting because I'll tell you right now, the third area is Jeremiah 30 verse 17. It says, I will restore health unto you and heal you of your wounds, saith the Lord. Now, when I saw this verse, God is my witness. When I saw the word heal you of your wounds, I heard in my spirit, God said, these are people that have belief and belief and belief. And they are saying, where is the manifestation? Wounds here are chronic sicknesses, chronic conditions, chronic ailments. Now, I just saw the word wounds, but God is telling me, even before I checked the Hebrew, all right, God is saying these wounds refer to chronic problems. So I started searching the word of God, and guess what I found? This word wounds is not the usual word of Christ took our koli. It's not koli, our sicknesses. It is the word actually that's used in Deuteronomy 28 for those who rebel against God, disobey His laws. God says, these curses will come on you, all right? You have great and prolonged plagues. The word great and prolonged plagues is exactly this word wounds, which means before even I search the Hebrew, God spoke to me. He's going to heal those of you who have long-term conditions. You almost gave up already. You believe God for other areas, but this area, you say, no one can do anything about it. Doctor says it's going to be, you know, I'm on medication for life. Well, God is saying, is it okay? I'll restore health to you, and I will heal you of those wounds. So get ready, people. Get ready. So I'll restore to you the years. I'll restore your soul, your mind. Many of you have come to the place, God spoke to me and God said that many of you have come to the place that you are saying, I used to be very sharp in my memory. I don't know why. Lately, I can't even seem to remember the very basic things. And the devil comes, the devil says, you have dementia. All right? And the devil says, you have Alzheimer. And the devil says, and there are some other medical terms, but I forgot to tell. The devil says, I forgot, what is it? So, the devil has been telling you these things, but I'm telling you, God wants to restore your mind. Amen. He restoreth my soul. The word nefesh in Hebrew is not just life, it's also the emotions and the mind, the soul part, the soulish part of man. God restores your soul. Amen. And it's amazing that when God restores, it's always greater in quality. I remember that I nearly lost my mind when I was a teenager, believing I had committed the unpardonable sin. And my mind was so terrible that I couldn't really study at the time. And I could have done better for my O-levels, except that I was going through this problem. And I used to be like, you know, we used to have like positions in class and all that. I used to be number one, number one, number one, number two, within five, the ranking. But during the last few years when I had that, you know, it just dropped. I just like, my mind, and I told myself, I'm the stupidest person, I can't even concentrate. When I read the Bible, I can't even concentrate. Nothing could pass my mind and be retained. Well, today, when I preach the Word of God, just to let you know, that was when I was a teenager, I was younger then. Today, I can see verses coming up. Now, I do not know the chapter and verse all the time, but I can see verses coming up. And my mind, if you talk to me about something, my mind can just go straight away to the passage and the interpretation, you know? And many a times, it's a gift, people. That's why I can preach without notes. So not bad for a guy, younger days, his mind, he can't even concentrate, to a time that right now, he's still young, but, you know, his mind is going, you know, in different directions. If anything, there is so many revelations sometimes to share. All right? So that is restoration, people. It's greater in quality. Amen. Okay? I don't encourage pastors to preach without notes. All right? It is a gift, people. It's not something that I achieved. I didn't read a book called How to Have Superpower Memory. No, I did not. I did not, okay? And I don't use these techniques and all that. It's a gift from God. And those things are with effort. These things are effortless. From God. So if you think that the devil is telling you are losing your mind, you are getting old faster, it is not true. He restoreth your soul this year. Amen. And has give you a mind that is stronger and sharper. Amen. Than your younger days. Amen. He will bring you back to the days of your youth. Amen. Your flesh shall be fresher than a child's. Amen. I just quoted the word of God to you from the book of Job. Your flesh shall be fresher than a child's. Amen, people? All right, praise the Lord. So these are the main areas. Restore to you the years, the wasted years. Restore to you your soul, all right? That includes a broken heart. He will restore to you your health. Amen. And heal you of your chronic wounds and conditions. Amen. Now, I mentioned just now, when God restores, it's greater in quality and quantity. Many times I say that real fast, but people may not know where it's from. Well, it's from the law of God. People say, I don't teach from the law. This is how you teach from the law. All right? Look at this in Exodus 22. If a man steals an ox or a sheep, it's a law, Mosaic law. If a man steals an ox or a sheep and slaughters it or sells it, he shall restore 5 oxen for an ox, 4 sheep for a sheep. That's God's law. God is a God that says, you know, I'm not going to just give that person who has been injured 1 sheep back for the sheep he lost. No, because of the crime done to him, he becomes a gainer. Are you listening, people? If you have lost an ox, you have lost, and I begin to meditate on this, 5 oxen for 1 ox, 4 sheep for a sheep. Why the difference? 5 for an ox, 4 for a sheep. Which is bigger, ox or sheep? Ox. And God said to me, the greater the loss, the greater the restoration. Amen. The greater your loss, the greater the restoration. Whether you've lost a child, you've lost a husband, a father, I'm telling you people, you'll have that. You may not get a father back, of course, but the thing is that you have 100-fold quality of fathering from people that come into your life. Amen. If you're a young girl, a young man, a teenager, you say, I don't have a father now. No. 1,000 times no. You have 100 fathers. Amen. Keep on coming to Varsity, Arrow, Dare. You'll find so much of father's love that sometimes you don't even find that at home. Amen. God can restore. But start saying, restore. Amen. Say again. Say it again. Say, Lord, restore. I just talk about the mind. Put your hand on your mind. Say, restore. Whoa, look out, look out. When God restores, it's what? 5-4-1. I believe that this guy who got robbed of his ox one day, after he got his 5 oxen for the one that's killed by the guy, by the perpetrator. One day he's sitting in his house, he told his wife, Martha, yes, Shlomo. You know, I'm so glad I got robbed. What do you mean, honey? Well, if I didn't get robbed, I would have 5 cows. You're right. And you know, Martha, that old cow, he was aging, he was getting old. He couldn't perform as much, you know. And if he died, we have no cow. But now, we have 5 cows. I'm glad for that thief. You come to that place. Are you listening, people? Amen? Come on, give praise to God. Hallelujah. That's what where sin increase, grace superabounds. God ordained in such a way.
This excerpt is brought to you by josephprince.com. To get the full message, visit josephprince.com.